pitcher who relies on the good two-seamer with the movement and the action down in the zone, something he can get by the hitter or get a ground ball out.
And that's over for a strike, 1-1. And they will be expecting, Steve, today that fastball to be the pitch that they're going to have to look for.
And they're going to have to go down to the zone and try to get him to elevate that pitch or get under it to drive it.
Hit hard on the ground to short. And Gonzalez picks it up and on the first to away.
Oh, Gary, he's pitching well right now. That's seven straight, but he's retired. He is really locked in.
All right, it's going to be Pelfrey, who is 1-for-1 with a bunt single. Yeah, he also has an RBI.
Here's the first pitch.
And, ooh, Phillips, nice catch on the line.
And
we'll
move down to the bottom half of the fourth inning.
Trying to gun someone out at first.
And Ramon Hernandez to bat. Drove in a run earlier in the game. Runner on first base, nobody out. Hernandez gets ready, first pitch. There's a strike from Pelfrey, and it's 0-1. Ramon Hernandez, not fooled by that. Count is even though.
Ooh, he overslides, but if you're unable to tag him out.
Good jump and able to get in there safely.
Spins of the throw behind the runner. Has to dive, but he's back in there in time. The pitch from Pelfrey. Ramon Hernandez, not fooled by that. Count is even though. He's ready. The 2-2 pitch. Fastball.
Got him.
And missed, struck him out, one away.
Pelfrey just blows him away with that fastball. That'll be the pitcher, Johnny Cueto. Like I said earlier, he can hit pretty well now for the Giants. It's honestly, I think it's something that, I don't know, that the Giants pitchers just have to do is be able to hit well. So that's something that I've noticed over the last couple of years. Their starting pitchers are all very good hitting pitchers. Now, Madison Bumgarner, great hitting pitcher with, I believe, more than 10 career home runs. And he had 3 last year. And Ty Block hit a home run last year. And Cueto is a good hitting pitcher. Samardzija hit a home run last year. And there's Stratton. I don't know about him hitting-wise. There's Suarez. And yeah. Pelfrey gets out of the inning. This game is tied after 4.
Fifth inning coming up here in Cincinnati. Shot there of their manager. And no doubt happy with the last inning on the mound. Now that focus is going to be in some good ABs. And here's Jose Reyes. Top 5 hits last year. And Hernandez sets up his target. He swings now and really hit that. And that's number 1.
Reyes flies out, and he's now 2-for-3.
Kicks and throws. That catches the other part of the plate for a strike.
He's painted the black way with that fastball, Gary. Hitting spots and with great velocity.
Swings, hits this one in the air. Down the
deep
right
down the line.
Line.
Bruce is going to make a nice catch.
Now it's two down.
Well, he saw the defense shifting to left, so he decided, let me try to go to right field with it. With the right fielder able to run it down.
And it's David Wright at the plate. Boy, does he get attention. There's no doubt about his ability. He has the ability every time he comes up to change a game.
Come on.
The 0-1 delivery of fastball taking for a strike.
I got a lot of star power right here, and a guy that can hit the ball out of the ballpark anytime he comes to the plate.
Swing and a line into right center. And that is in there, the go-ahead run on board.
All right, two out, single for the Mets. Might not do anything this inning, but could be important later, as it could get Cueto out earlier. And that also stops Cueto's streak of, I believe, 9 consecutive batters retired. Our little two-out thunder going on. Let's see if the Mets can take the lead back.
And Carlos Delgado to bat.
Fans love power. Managers love power. Heck, we love power, Gary. And we've got a big power hitter coming up right here.
And this is bat already 0-1. First pitch was a strike.
The reason people like power is that
there's a swing and a drive.
Deep right field. Back at the track, but nothing amounts to the two-out hits for the Mets, and the bottom of the fifth is coming up. His heat and Phillips shows his bat speed, but unable to make contact.
Good eye by Brandon Phillips. It's even.
Scouting reports indicate when the count is 1-1, he's really aggressive. So I'm being real careful on this pitch.
He watches the 1-1 pitch.
1-2 with the four-seam fastball at 96 miles an hour.
1-2 count. He doesn't like to mess around. Look for him to go right at him with the heater.
Deep left field. That ball is off the wall. So that's a leadoff double for the Reds. Castillo making the catch on that one.
And it's Edwin Encarnacion at the plate. Struck out swinging last time. And on second, one away. Spins, checks him at second. And he dives back safely. One out, a runner on at second base. Jones' first look. Too low on that one for a ball, 1-0.
This guy has an explosive fastball today. I think the hitter is going to be looking to get a read on it. If they can catch up to it...
See, Pelfrey actually does have an explosive fastball. But he goes with the curveball there and gets Encarnacion out in front. Murphy's throw just a little bit late, and Phillips is going to come in and score. And the Reds have got the lead. Jay Bruce does exactly what the Reds wanted him to do, and he gets in that run.
Here, we just saw a big hit right there, and it points out how critical it is at this time of the game to have somebody who can step up and get the job done in a clutch situation. And now it comes down to can their bullpen hold this lead.
And Gomes watches it go by. Count is even. Steve, exactly right. You got to believe what they're thinking about is put away time now.
Well, that's right. It's not just about the offense. It's going to be about their pitching as well. They're going to win as a team or lose as a team. Let's see if they can win as a team.
And Gomes watches it go by. Count is even.
Gary, he's aggressive on the 2-2 count, so he's going to go down. He's going down swinging. Let's see if the pitcher can hit his spot.
Here's a fly ball to straightaway left. And that'll do it. Reyes puts it away. Well, they score once on two.
Rip Pelfrey, good inning, but still gives up a run. And gives up the lead. Mets have got a 3-2 lead after five.
There's the skipper, Dusty Baker. You know what he needed out of his lineup that last time through? This lead now something he can try to protect if he can get some solid pitching. Pickett is the batter now. And he lays it down here trying to beat it out. Cueto, throw is not
a gone is going to get in there safely.
Well, it's a great bunt right there. Well executed. He turned around late in the box to surprise the infielders, got it down, and legged it out.
And in the batter's box, it's Murphy. Blew out last time. No one out and a runner on first. And here's the first one. There's a swing and a smack. He dives.
Oh, Chris Dickerson. With a spectacular catch in center.
Shows some outstanding speed just to catch up with this thing.
Well, this is an all or nothing effort right here. If he doesn't get it, it's extra base.
And we're going to see Snyder here. He bounced out his last time. One out, runner on at first. Oh, and he takes off for second.
Pagan is thrown out at second.
He got him. Good pitch to throw on, Steve.
Well, he had the fastball, and it was set up in the right spot. He had a quick release.
Just did not get a good jump.
The pitch, out, foul, straight back. Lined right at the second baseman. Throws on the first, side is retired. No runs, one hit, and no one left on deck. Cincinnati, they're maintaining their advantage. gets ready. First pitch. Oh, he lost control of that one, and that gets him.
Pelfrey hits Hernandez. Pelfrey throws Cueto out. Nice play.
Gotta be a successful pitcher. You have to be able to pitch and field your position, but you also have to handle the bat. That's what you do right there.
That number nine spot, Steve, a lot of people say that's just a waste. That's an automatic out. That's how you take and get something out of it.
That's how you help yourself when you're a pitcher. Big time players live for these moments like this, Gary.
One of the most difficult situations for players to come through in this game. That's when you got a runner out there and two down.
Well, the game's best clutch hitters handle the pressure. They keep themselves intense while not getting tense. Let's see if he can do it.
Two outs and a runner on second. The pitch. Swings on that first pitch. Ooh. Fastball.
Nickerson taking a big rip at it. Fastball right down the middle. 0-2.
Up in the zone to drive a little bit. That's why he went down to the zone for that four seam.
Trying to get him to go after that curve. 1-2.
They tried to go back door with the curveball right there, but just couldn't catch the outside corner.
1-2 pitch coming. Change up.
Pelfrey gets him. That will end the sixth.